Very good morning to all the children once again. We have already jotted down the key points of the chapter. Please have a look on the board. It's for you people, not for me. Okay. So very first chapter name is The Last Lesson though, but it is the first chapter of your book. Clear? As you know that your exams are about to start in the end of October. Pre-boards are there in the mid of November. You're going to go through the first term of CBSE. So you never know what sort of questions will be there. So what I'm going to do is I will be discussing the whole chapter in detail as if we have done earlier. In detail, we will be discussing. And then on daily basis, I will be sending you some questions also in the assignment group. Clear for all the children. Though you will be getting meritorious students are added into the group. Raise your hands. Kone. Fine. You will be getting assignments there also. You have to solve it. Doesn't mean you got it that you won't be seeing to it. Go through all the questions, answer it, and then answer key will be shared next day. Mark, give marks to yourself. How many marks you are scoring? Where do you stand? You should know. Then confusions we will discuss. Okay, this question was that and all in the later period. Fine. So, but for rest of the other students also, I will be sharing some content in the assignments group. Go through the questions. It doesn't mean that only meritorious student will be getting the assignments. You will also be getting assignments on daily basis. Whatever chapter we will complete in the class, I will be sharing one PDF of that quiz-based MCQs in the assignment group. Go through it. Clear? Kuch nahi samajh mein aayega. Next day we will discuss before starting this. Fine. So correctors now. Franz and M. Hamel. M. Hamel, which language he teaches in the class? French language. So he is teacher of French language and he has been teaching there since 40 years. It's a long span of time. A person who has been teaching since 40 years is obviously emotionally attached to the institution, to his own language also. That is the mother tongue of people of Elzec and Lorraine. Fine, these are the names of the district you should know of France. Elzec and Lorraine, bar bar, repeat where you name. So these are the districts of France. And which language is the mother tongue? French language. Now, one of the themes is impact of war. When one country invades the other, they do not want to invade only the geographical area. They want to invade into the languageism also. They want to, you know, have the control and power that our language should supersede and their language should be subdued and suppressed. They should not speak their own mother tongue. So when Russia invaded France, you should know these facts. Fine. I'm writing P, P silent. Fine. Russia invaded France. What they wanted their language, Russian language, to be imposed in the districts of France. German and Russian, both same, fine. So German language will be imposed, or the language of Russian people is German only, fine. So German language will be imposed in the district of Elzec and Lorraine. Spelling of Elzec and Lorraine, you should know. So these are the names of two districts where this chapter is set. France and Hamel belong to these districts, fine. So Elzec and Lorraine, two districts of France, and Russia has invaded these districts. And now the people who are living there, they have to, they won't be getting chance to learn French language now. So that was announced. Clear? That is impact of war. Now, firstly, characters are introduced to you. France is a young boy who is very casual approach he's having towards the studies. He never bothers to listen to the lectures of the teachers. So he is not listened to M. Hamel, French, senior teacher of French in a very good way. And he was getting late for school. The chapter starts, that's why I just picked up this sentence. The chapter starts when France was getting late to school that day. That day is that day when they're going to know that particular day that they won't be able to learn French language from the next day onwards. Clear? So this is the biggest change in their lives. Then when he was getting late to school, as he was not having interest, he was scared that when he will reach late, M. Hamel is going to scold me. Number one, for getting late. Number two, for not doing my homework in the participles. One topic was given by the teacher. Verbal adjectives, jinko bol dete hain. So he has given the topic of participles. He did not prepare and he was scared that if I will reach late. So he was having the confusion whether should I go to school or not. But then he decided up to go to school only. Yeah. Then changes seen or noticed by Franz on the way. First thing, when he was getting late to school, he passed by a bulletin board. There happened to be a bulletin board on which all the news from, you can say, what is going on in the districts, because they were not having good communication devices like a television and all. Media was not that at great level used during those days. So whatever news used to come through the bulletin board, whatever was written, they would read it, right? So he happened to pass the bulletin board. There was a huge crowd over there. So first unusual thing or change noticed by Franz, that there was a crowd in front of the bulletin board, that news board. Clear? He thought that what is there that people are standing? Then two people pointed him out also in a funny way. So when he was going, but he did not pay attention. He was running to the school only. Then he reaches to the campus of the school. Another unusual thing. Earlier, whenever he used to enter, when you enter the school, there is a lot of commotion, noise, rapping of the ruler, tapping of the ruler on the desk. Drawers are being opened and closed. A lot of commotion and noise used to be there. But that day, there was silence. So second unusual thing, he thought that why there is no commotion, no movement. What is there different today? So Franz was amazed. He was shocked in a way. Then he enters the classroom. Third thing he's going to notice. When he enters, he thought, now my teacher is going to scold me, maybe giving me punishment and all. He was a very disciplined teacher, M. Hemmel, though he was a good teacher. So he, rather than scolding him, when Franz reaches there, he says, oh, we were starting without you. Little boy, take your seat. So he was shocked. Teacher did not utter a word of scolding to me. He was surprised. Then he sat over there. After sitting, he realizes when he entered, the most, you got this question, the most unusual thing of all. These are the unusual things by far. But the most unusual thing is when he saw the villagers, the people who belong to different professions. Fine, they are sitting at the back benches carrying their equipments with them, but they did not go to work that day. Straight away, dressed up in their own way, they are sitting at the back benches in the M. Hemmel's class. That was the most unusual thing. And then another most unusual thing, not the most unusual, but the unusual thing is the dressing sense of the teacher. He was wearing which colored coat? Green colored, very good. So green colored long coat he was wearing and collared shirt and his dressing sense, which he used to wear during the inspection days or if any school function was there. So that day, neither a function was there nor any inspection. So that again clicked into his mind that what is unusual that he's wearing dressed up in a very formal manner. So these are the lists of this. Anshul, please stand and count on fingers how many unusual things. Please explain to us. Very good. You were listening today. That's why I asked. In English. Firstly. This is English. Is this English? In English, you have to speak. Try to. You can. Yes. First thing you notice the bulletin board outside. In the sequence, tell me. Bulletin board then. Yes. Very good. Then he enters the class. Yes, very good. Then villagers. And the last thing, dressing sense of the teacher. Very formal. Very good. So he can speak. Why? Making a joke out of it. He can also speak. That is good. Fine. So Anshul gave all the points. Only last point he missed. That was the dressing sense of the teacher was formally dressed up. So let's continue now. Unusual things I mentioned. Now, theme is there, importance of one's own language, nations or native language, I must say. One's own language is your native language, fine? It's not some religion-based language or regional language, fine? So, importance of education, impact of war, importance of the present also. Many multiple themes are layered into this chapter. But basically, your own language is the key to your own freedom. You are imprisoned. Fine. Unless and until you do not know your own language, you do not have the key or access to the freedom of your life. So this is what is projected by M. Hemmel in the chapter. So what happens? He starts. Now you should know what was the content of the last lesson also. So teacher started asking, firstly, the previous day homework. He started asking questions on participles. He asked students. He asked Franz also. Franz started in a confident way, but he messed up everything. He was so nervous. he could not give the answer. He was scared. So again, teacher corrected him by providing the correct answer rather than scolding him. Fine. Abhi tak, France doesn't know that what announcement is being made by this teacher. He's having the doubts in his mind, the unusual things and what is happening, why people are sitting at back and all. But till now, he doesn't know. So when teacher started with the content of the last lesson, okay, what was there? Firstly, he brought beautiful notebooks of, you can say, writing. He had already written Else Clauren. That was for the junior kids. He has brought and he distributed all the students those notebooks in which Else Clauren was written so that they can write the names of districts. Actually, what is it is projecting here? Teacher is projecting. He's very emotional and he's associated with these districts and his language only. So in French language, it was written. And he gave a lesson of writing that day. Whatever he could give in one go, he was giving. Last day, you come to the exam, ma'am, mujhe lesson ka theme bata do. So in whatever, in 2 minutes, what we can do in 2 minutes, whatever we can tell, we tell you. In that way, in one lecture, he taught writing. Fine. He gave the lesson of reading, whatever skills he could cover up. Then there was one person sitting at the back. He was also having those, you can say, primary books in which basic words are written related to French language. He was also helping the junior kids to write. Clear? So this is it in the writing. In the last lesson he taught, and he was so emotional that day, the teacher, that he could not even speak when the class he wanted to dismiss. He made the most startling, surprising announcement that this is the last lesson, last French lesson. So now everybody knows France got to know at that time. So at that time, the state of mind of the France was so shattered. He was thinking, now that day he was understanding everything in a clear-cut manner. For the whole session, he did not listen to the teacher. It means problem is with the students mostly. We say, hame is teacher ka samajh mein nahi aata hai. We always usually say, but because we do not try to listen to the teacher, the problem is that. That day, Franz understood each and every word of the teacher. He understood everything and he was, you know, having the feeling of remorse, pachtava, repenting, that why could not I learn earlier? And now he was, time has slipped out of his hands. From next day onwards, German language will be replacing the French language. So that announcement was made by a teacher and he was so shocked, he was missing, and he started having good emotions towards the teachers also. So that was the state of mind of France. Clear? When teacher was teaching, pigeons were cooing on the rooftop of the class. Now France gets a question in his mind, will they make them sing in German, even the pigeons? This is the question. What does it mean? It has deeper meaning. Will they? They means the people who has invaded, Russian people. Means they are invading us. They are forcing us to learn their language. Can they change our birds and pigeons also? This is a question of a child to the people who are creating warlike circumstances. That you can invade our country, you can invade our boundary and LOC and line of control and whatever. But you cannot invade the minds of the people. If they love their language, they will love their language. Forcefully, nothing can be taught to any person. So actually, this is what he is trying to say, that one country can geographically invade us, but mentally they cannot invade us. Yes, they try to, but will they make our pigeons also sing in German? Fine. In that way, he asks. So that is a satirical situation. Then importance of education also in the form of France, how he missed it, and impact of war also. Clear? So in the last, what happens? M. Hamel, asked Franz also to recite. He stood still. Then he himself gave the answer. Then he, very important thing, he talked of the, at the end of the lesson, when he taught his, gave his lesson in writing and reading and last day homework also he asked. He told about them the importance of mother tongue. Fine, Franz, that was the part of last lesson. Last lesson mein teacher ne kya kya padhaya, importance of mother tongue. He calls the French language, he says that your language is the key to their prison. If you are imprisoned and if you know the language of your own country, you are not imprisoned then. But if you are imprisoned by the other country and you do not know the language of your own country, obviously if they will be teaching Russian and eventually you will forget French, then you will remain in prison forever. This is what teacher is trying to say. Clear? So he's saying that your own language should be there. He calls the French language the most clearest, the most logical, the most beautiful. Teen words when you use here. The most beautiful, clearest and logical language of the world, because he was so attached with this. Clear? And his sister of this M. Hamel, she was packing the trunks fine that day in the room above, as they had to leave the country the very next day. Even then, with so dedication, he was teaching. The next day, he is about to leave the country. Fine. So everybody was sitting motionless. Everybody was emotional. They had lesson in grammar also. They had lesson in writing also that day. Clear? The content of the last lesson, I'm telling you. Firstly, he asked the questions on participle. They had lesson in writing. They had lesson in grammar. Then they got to know the importance of French language also. And at last, after writing, they had a lesson in history also, right? And then the babies chanted their, you can say, walls, baby, jaise aapke A, E, I, O, U hote hain. In that way, French language mein, they have written ba, be, bi, bo, bu, right? In that way. So they learned their walls. So people, old Hauser, one of the people from different professions, some was about to paint the wall, some was from another profession. One Hauser sitting at the back, he was crying. So people, villagers were becoming emotional. That was the scene of the classroom. And all at once, the church clock struck 12. Us time pe church pe na bells bajti thi. That time is means that 12 o'clock ho gaye. And then midday prayers, the time of midday prayers also. There are different intervals at which you perform your prayers. And at the same time, at that when church clock struck 12, Russians, you can say, were playing their, you can say, drums outside. At the same moment, trumpets of the Russians, trumpets, they were beating. That was a sign that now we have invaded. So their drill was going on. Dhawan is entering the class always, once in a while, once or twice in a month, and at the end of the, always. I don't know why he does that. So he, yes, M. Hamel, you know, after hearing the trumpets, soldiers returning from drill, what he does, he stood up from his chair, and that day he was looking so tall to France when he observed him. And he could not speak. His throat choked with emotion. Choked, ye wala choke mat likh diya na, this is choked. C-H-O-K. So he was emotional. He could not speak. So rather than speaking or saying goodbye or bidding goodbye, he wrote on the board, Viva la France. Means? So it is a wish. It is a blessing of the teacher to his own profession. It is a wish or suppressed emotion of the teacher to all the, it's a blessing for all. He wanted everyone to learn French language so that at least in their language, their country will be surviving. So he says, Viva la France means long live France. And with that, when he wrote those three words, he could not even, you know, turn and look into the eyes of the students and villagers. He just with his hand, he made the gesture like this. It means class is dismissed. Fine. He dismissed the class with a gesture. I say, chalo, aapki class bhi dismiss ho gayi.